one of the things we've talked about before is a lot of the issues that firefighters face in terms of their union collective begging agreements. And so that's what they call them here, is collective begging. So like, and the different issues that most people have no idea that their insurance will cover some types of cancer, but not other types of cancer, like this ridiculous stuff. I know a lot of that is state stuff, but that is something that we cover a lot. So I don't know if that's something that you follow, or if you, I mean, you're probably aware of coworkers that have issues with insurance and health.
Yeah, it's a huge consideration. And the only thing you got to remember is that insurance companies are corporations. That's the formula. And your interests and your health and your well-being and you down the road 6 months, a year from now, really are not their bottom line. Their bottom line is their bottom line. So, you know, there's guys, even as we speak, sitting in rooms trying to figure out how to skin the, you know, the equation even greater, to a greater degree, all the time. And it's sad. It's sad. Where are you going to find people to do these occupations, these jobs, if they're not properly insured?
Yeah. So talk about how you ended up getting involved in being a firefighter in the first place, because I know that wasn't your first career, and where that came from. And it's very admirable to me that you do that as a, I mean, it's admirable to me that anyone does it at all, but to, especially to do it as a volunteer.
Let me just, this fellow,
his name
was Captain Patrick Brown. He was the captain of Ladder 3 in New York City, FDNY, and he fell on 9/11. He was my best friend. I'm actually sitting in the room that used to be his room. I turned it into a kind of an office. And so when Patrick was missing, I went to the site of the World Trade Center with his brother Michael and searched for him and couldn't find him. And then, you know, after we did find him, and I moved out of New York City to where I am now, and it's volunteer. And I said, why should it be Joe and Jim and George? Why can't it be me? And then I embarked on what's called Firefighter One. We have a tremendous academy here in Suffolk County. It took me the full 2 years to get it all done. And you know, at 41 years old, I was training with guys who were 20, 21, 22, which was, I thought it was fun. I thought it was interesting. It was fascinating. It was like, how did I get here? So I should think that the first time I operated as a firefighter, I didn't even realize, but my fire service is dedicated to the memory of my friend.
That's really awesome.
Well, it's awesome until it's 2 o'clock in the morning and you're getting out of bed, you know, going on EMS runs and stuff like that.
I was going to say 41 to 61 is a big difference too.
Yeah. You know, it's an abstraction. I'd like to help. I'd like to do. I'd like to volunteer. It's an abstraction. But then it gets pulled down off the wall and it becomes a reality. Do you know what I mean? And so therein lies the tale.
How is that?
It's good. Sometimes when I do acting and like I get a call at 3 o'clock in the morning for a heart attack victim, and then I have to come back home and try and sleep and get up at 5 and go, go to an acting job, someone's not getting their money's worth.
Right. Okay. So you're okay, but I would hope that if you're spread thin, that it's not like potentially victims and fires that are getting the shorter end of the stick. Like if something.
Certainly not. No. Even right now, I'm monitoring, you know, what's happening. I'm on a modified kind of schedule right now because I tweaked my back at a fire last weekend. Actually, not at the fire. I worked hard at the fire, but we had a rekindle. It started again 50 hours later. We were over there working on it. And I tweaked my back pretty good. So I took a couple of days off here.
Okay. You realize that's a really badass thing though, at your age. Like most people like that I know when they tweak their back, it's from like sneezing, getting out of bed.
No, there's plenty of those tweaks too, believe me, you know.
I think it goes without saying that, you know, just what firefighters do, as Jen, what do you like to call firefighters?
No, it's superheroes.
Yeah.
That's the closest you get to real life superheroes. And to me, and I always say cops wish they were as cool as firefighters. They wish they were as cool as firefighters. Wow. I can't.
I had a New York City police officer who became a firefighter. And he said to me, hey, Bob, you know why I became a firefighter instead of a cop? I said, no, Joe, why? He says, because I wanted to help people.
Right.
I was like, wait a minute, don't policemen help it? You know, but he really just was given over to just solely helping people as opposed to I don't know what else. But I thought that was always very funny and innocent in a way.
Thanks for watching. If you want to support our mission to transform politics into service, please like this video, subscribe, follow us on social media, and consider joining our Patreon, where you'll get early access to our interviews as well as other exclusive content. Links are in the description. Peace out.